Just imagine you are a young body nationalist looking for a coach to take you to the next level, and suddenly you have a chance to learn from your idol. For Geoffrey Loi, that is not some far-fetched dream, as the 23-year-old has the chance of learning from the Chinese table tennis legend Zhang Yining. And I'm just curious, how does the world and Olympic champion pass on her skills and expertise to the next generation of hopefuls?
现在要罗伊，所以你现在回忆你在巴西第一次见到他的时候，那个时候的他是什么样的？嗯，给我的感觉，他对乒乓球那种热诚，其实他们家爸爸、哥哥有姐姐都会打球，到他那儿去见他第一次的时候，给我印象比较深的是他对乒乓球的那种特别想打好的那种心情。我觉得他是一个这种勤奋好学的这么一个队员吧。
其实早上问他，你WTT最开始排名多少？他说他是记不清了，可能得600以后了。然后我说你现在排多少？他说160，我刚搜了一下，还真是160了。所以这其实是中国乒乓的魔力，是吗？来这儿学了，从18年到现在，然后18年到23年，5年的时候高了500名。
我觉得那会儿其实自己也是正在冲顶的这么一个大的阶段，一个周期，因为那会儿还没有拿到自己特别向往的奥运会的女单金牌，在那个路上遇到的这个挫折坎坷，我可能输球是肯定要有的，而且在这种输球很痛心的这种情况下，怎么总结、怎么调整，然后怎么坚定不移、怎么坚信啊，相信自己这条路，真的不是一方想象的那种一帆风顺，都是在赢，一直是在站在领奖台那个鲜花和掌声的，走到这个背后，其实有很多东西都需要去磨练的。 对，在这一个大的周期里面，给我这个当运动员这一个大的路上，这么长的路上，我觉得做了一个很大的一个铺垫，对，让我也成长了很多吧。5年是一个大的周期，因为奥运会是4年，对于18岁到23岁，我23岁拿到了雅典的冠军。
付出得到了收获吧。除了技术之外，你觉得乒乓球你最想教会他们的是什么？
我觉得还是那种克服困难，然后想到解决的办法，就是用解决办法这种能力去举一反三。其实不是只是打乒乓球，就是用打乒乓球这个道理用到各行各业，对吧？用到学业上。
那么其实，不光是。 我们的罗伊，其实中国乒乓球学院在海外有了分院，有了训练基地，有越来越多的来自世界各地喜欢乒乓球的、喜欢中国乒乓，把你们视为偶像的年轻一代的乒乓球选手都能看到我们的学院和加入，想加入这里。对于这些更年轻一代的选手和这些乒乓爱好者，你想对他们说点什么？
我当然希望有更多的人能参与到乒乓球当中来，因为作为现在退役的这个乒乓人来说呢。
也是冰山一角，因为体育是一个很特殊的一个大块儿。我也希望家家都有一个乒乓球台子，大家哪怕抽出一个小时的时间，每天能打打球，至少能把手机放下。
虽然你的外号是大魔王，其实我早上问罗伊，我问他，他知不知道你中文外号？他说他不知道。然后我跟他说了你中文外号，我跟他用英语直译了一下，他很惊讶，他觉得不可能。 就是我教练这么温柔，他不可能叫这个名字。
给他吓着了，你也是。
不是他不知道，其实咱这个是用那个是不是游戏版的那种？
对，有点游戏版。
带有可爱但又很厉害的那种状态，给他直接翻译过去不可能。我的教练特别和蔼，他
是啊，看我现在是严厉的教练吗？你的是啊。今天上午我也跟教练组那儿聊天，我说哎，真的乒乓球太难练了，又得注意发力，还得注意还原，还得注意下一板，还连接，就是技术上一大堆都需要注意。所以你说跟队员教起来的时候，确实他练起来真的是没有十年的功夫，没有十年的这种基础，你说谈什么手上感觉真的是很难。再加上十年你都不见得能打出什么样的特别像样的成绩，都有可能的，这种可能存在的。因为我开始还真没觉得乒乓球特别难练，然后呢我进到国家队的以后，还到了国家一队，我发现这个项目确实跟我想象的不一样，好像就是我一开始觉得人人都应该会打乒乓球，我老有这种感觉。后来呢发现哎呀，这怎么那么难练呢？
在你的眼里面乒乓球是一个什么样的运动？它为什么一直在吸引你？退役了以后还一直愿意坚守在这里？
我觉得现在真的是割舍不下了，因为开始当运动员的时候，我就觉得为什么不去尝试一个新的职业，或者是换换，天天都在这个球馆里泡着，好累啊。但是后来我发现，我根本放不下。
对于更多的这么多年一直在关注你、喜欢中国乒乓的来自世界各地的朋友们，又想对他们说些什么？
反正乒乓球真的是带给我自己很多，让我自己学会了什么是坚持，什么是信念，什么是突破，最后什么是超越自己吧。但对于广大球迷来说，我希望让他们自己在乒乓球上面也能悟出一些道理来，然后用到自己的工作当中去，生活当中去。对，这是我最大的愿望。
In Loi's eyes, learning from a table tennis legend would have been pretty much unthinkable for him in the past.
Have you seen her training and playing video competition videos?
Yes, yes, yes.
How does that make you feel?
It's really amazing, and you know, I like how she played, and I saw all the matches that she won, and those medals and everything, so I got inspired by herskills and techniques, and you know, yeah, everything she got is just wonderful. Yeah, the first time I met her, it was in 2018. They came to my country, and yeah, so I met her in my country. So the first time I met her was, you know, I was surprised, and you know, it's a different feeling. I was out of words as well, yeah, but I was really happy to see her in person. AndYou know, we took some photos, yeah. I was really nervous the first time, you know. That time, we know that she was the queen of table tennis, yeah.
Actually, among Chinese fans, she got another nickname. You can literally translate it to the devil, the demon, meaning that she is so good that no one can win over her basically at that time. But so what does it make you feel, the nickname by Chinese fans of her?
It's a really wonderful name, you know? It's like a superhuman.
Yeah. So actually, when you actually trained with her, so is she a strict coach or funny coach? What kind of coach she is to you?
She's not really strict to me or to the, my teammates. She's really friendly and very kind, and you know, and she's humble as well, yeah. She's a good coach, yeah.
I heard you're actually not the only table tennis player of your family. Your father and your siblings, they all play table tennis. Yeah. So just tell their stories to us. And I heard your father is a national champion in your country, right?
Yes. Before, yeah, when he was in high school, yeah, that's when he started playing table tennis. And he won 2 bronze medals. That's the first time for my country to get medals in table tennis. But they got medal in men's team. In 2003 or 2004, he retired, yeah. That's when he got married and he got 4 kids, yeah. In my family, I have 2 elder sisters. And 1 elder brother. I'm the last in the family.
They all play table tennis?
Yes. They all play table tennis. Before I was small, they were all representing my country. When my age goes to 8 years old, that's where I started playing table tennis because of the influence of my father.
When your father know you're gonna be coached by the legend Zhang Yining, what's his reaction?
It was a different, you know, yeah, feeling. He was very, very happy, yeah, when I was coached by Zhang, yeah.
What has he told you at that time?
He told me that everything she tell you, you have to listen to her. Because they are the, you know, champions, yeah.
Yeah.
That's what my father told me. No matter you, when in trainings, you don't do the right thing, when she fix that wrong things to you, you have to do it. No matter you fail or, yeah, you have to keep on doing it, yeah.
We not only have a Chinese table tennis college here in Shanghai, we also have a college back in your country. And what does that college mean to all the table tennis lovers, especially younger generation?
Before, we used to hire venues for trainings and competitions as well. But after that, training center operated by the Chinese. After the building, they built a training center. It helps a lot, not only the elite athletes, not only the national team, but you know, it's good for the young generation as well. So they can start in good facilities and, you know, good equipments and everything.
Among the current generation of the national team players, who is your favorite?
Fan.
Fan Zhendong?
Yes.
Yes. You like his style of playing?
Yes, I like his style.
Sharing Chinese table tennis with the world. With the story resonating with more and more people worldwide, Zhang Yining and Loi were even invited to the 3rd Belt and Road Forum for International Cooperation. Shi Zhihao, a former Team China head coach and now the dean of China Table Tennis College, said the institution is now welcoming more young international students to its campus.
First, I think his change, his character has opened up a lot.第一次我去的时候，他看到我们都很拘束，讲话也很腼腆，他又本身性格就比较内向。从18年以后他来到上海，应该有5到6次了吧，差不多加起来总体的时间，光到上海来，在上体大，在中国乒乓球学院训练的话，大概有4到5个月了时间。这样的话呢，和对我们也比较了解了。他们，我想他也是一个很朴实的一名运动员。他运动成绩提高了嘛，他对你的信任程度，他确实感觉我们中国人确实是真心的在帮助他。在前几次的时候呢，我已经跟他学过，我说你要打好乒，想乒乓球打好，必须把中文学好，对吧？我说因为乒乓球是英国人发明的，但是中国人会打得这么好，一定是有中国的文化在里面。所以我是这么要求的。那么我相信，在你中文能够达到比较流畅的，可以跟我们中国人沟通的话，那么我相信你的乒乓球水平一定会有一个大的飞跃。本身中国乒乓球学院成立的时候，我还在国家队任女队主教练，他是2010年挂牌的，我是2012年伦敦奥运会结束以后就来了。那么我作为张怡宁来讲，他也希望他在退役以后有一个转型，对吧？不光是会打乒乓球，他还要会教乒乓球。体育运动本身也是个国际语言，大家从事乒乓球的时候，哪怕从事篮球的时候，从事任何一个体育项目，就不用语言来交流了。那么我想呢，就是说作为乒乓球来讲，我们也从中国乒乓人来讲，也有一个好的优良传统。